Let's come to order. I'd like to welcome everybody to our Monday, March 28, 2016, commission meeting. Under regular business, a review of minutes from the March 14, 2016, commission meeting. Is there any additions, deletions, or corrections? Hearing none?
Yes.
Okay.
We do have a correction. The prior minutes did not put a fund on the budget amendment for the health department, and we needed that to be public buildings, repair and maintenance of the health department. Fund 112 needs to go on those minutes.
Okay. Ms. Erb, make sure that gets changed. Any other corrections, sir? All right. Hearing none, review a memorandum of warrants for a period of March 10, 2016 through March 23, 2016. Ms. McDuffie?
Yes, Chairman. The memorandum of warrants for the period stated equaled $1,288,184.
Thank you. Any questions? Under new business, Lee Macon, Revenue Commissioner, mailing contract with Diversified Companies, LLC. Mr. Macon, you want to come speak to that?
I will. This is just going to replace the contract we have with ARISTA to do our mail-outs for tax bills for appraisal notices. And actually, this company here will do our certified mail-outs, which we've been doing ourselves. So kind of something we've been trying to find a company that does, and they do. I think it'll be improved service. Other than that, that's really all I have. If you have any questions.
Any questions about the new contract? It's just replacing the existing contract. All right. Thank you. Next, consider bond issue resolution for energy savings improvement to county facilities. Mr. Byer, you want to speak to this? This is a parameters resolution, is that correct?
Yes, sir, it is. This would be the item that would take the additional energy savings and put in the up to $4 million of improvements. We originally had programmed $2 million, but after the full audit came back in, we're actually going to be able to do $4 million worth. So we ended up having to go back and seek some financing mechanisms. We had three companies that actually returned those, and Merchants Capital had the best interest rate for the terms that we were asking for from all three companies. So I think we sent it out to nine different entities, and we got three proposals back.
All right. Thank you. Any questions about this? This is not actually doing the bond issue. It's just setting the parameters for the bond issue. All right, next, consider drug task force budget amendment. Ms. McDuffie, do you have that?
Yeah, turn your mic on.
And the, I'm sorry, the general fund pays for the drug task force salaries, and what I would like to do is show the full effect of the expenditures in the 163 fund, which is the drug task force. So basically, per grant agreement, the drug task force pays the salaries back to the general fund. So it's like a swapping of money, but it needs to be shown in the drug task force fund. So when they fill out their grant papers, it will show as drug task force expenditures. So that's what we're doing. We're swapping money. General fund pays it over to the drug task force, and then on a monthly basis, they pay it back to the general fund for salaries. So we're just swapping money.
There's no additional revenue or anything is required. It's just showing.
That's correct.
Just identifying revenue.
Normally what happens is over about May or June, they run out of money to be paying the general fund, and the general fund still pays their salary. So what we're doing is we're just that additional money, and then they'll turn around and pay it back to the general fund.
Any questions on this? All right, hearing none. Discuss county engineer executing lease for office copier pursuant to State of Alabama Contract T-190. Mr. Byer.
Mr. Chairman, Commissioners, our current machine has been out of lease for about 6 months, but under the state contract, you've continued to pay the same rate that you had for that monthly lease. This would put us in a new machine within a couple dollars of what our current lease is. So basically, it's a replacement lease.
All right. Any questions for the engineer? Next, consider authorizing engineer to execute agreement with ADM for scrap tire cleanup on county right-of-way for remainder FY 16, 17, and 18. Mr. Fire.
Mr. Chairman, Commissioners, this will, we had in the past had a $100,000 annual grant program with ADM to do the same type of work, clean up scrap tires on the right-of-way. After some budget cuts to them in the past two legislative cycles, they have amended that program to set a $125,000 grant program up for a period of basically 2.5 years. They went ahead and most of the grant agreements ended or will end at the end of this month. So this will take that up. That won't be a it's additional revenue. If we can get $100,000, it lets us get up to $100,000. But I don't think typically we've been able to secure a full $100,000 a year. So this will not impact us. It'll help keep us with our litter crews and our cleanup and cleaning up the right of ways. This is not for private right of way. I mean private cleanup. There's a whole other program with ADM for that. So this is just what's on the right of ways.
Okay. Any questions? Next, discuss agreement with ADM for scrap tire fund marketing demonstration project.
Mr. Chairman, Commissioners, I believe it was last fiscal year, FY15, y'all had a group come to you from the Learning Tree over in Tallahassee wanting an appropriation for repaving a parking area that they use for a playground for special needs. We have worked with them with Commissioner Taylor over the last 12, 15 months and with ADM. ADM has a grant program to put down a basically a polymer rubberized tire, scrap tire playground material that will substitute for the asphalt paving that they wanted to put in their play area, parking area, not really parking area, I guess it was old parking area they turned into a play area. And we've been finally successful in getting it again. This is another thing that has been subject to budget cuts. That's why it has taken so long. We thought we had it at the end of last fiscal year, but because of all their cuts, they had to reevaluate how much money they could give. And they it's a little under $30,000 they're putting towards this project. Y'all have no match in this. This is you're basically a conduit to put it out there as a test project.
Thank you. Any questions? Next, consider FY16 local road program, Mr. Byer.
In front of you, you've got a couple spreadsheets, one that looks color-coded and then one with a map. These are similar to what you saw at the last commission meeting in my report. We have removed one road off that project list, Little Kalijah Road, that'll have to wait until next year because we just will not have the time to be able to get to the paving. We're going to try to do the reclamation and sealing on it. And just so you know, there's another list included that shows all the roads that we're going to be reclaiming, sealing, and many other projects, just so you have an idea that what's planned for 16 and 17. But most of the projects on this list are projects that we have worked with other entities, Tallahassee City, Tallahassee Board of Education, Elmore, Wetumpka, in addition to several county projects and county facility projects, judicial complex. So what we're asking for tonight is just approval of these projects so we can move on to the next phase using our annual contracts to execute these and have especially the projects with Tallahassee done during the summer months when school was out, because both of all five of their projects basically are related to work around their schools or the main road that runs in front of them. You'll remember Friendship Road was tied to an A-trip project and some funding swap. So most all these that are highlighted in colors except the yellow at the bottom are all being reimbursed back to the county. So y'all are passing through helping the cities out by doing this.
All right. Any questions about our local road program for the summer? Next, on the consent docket, approve eliminating one tag clerk position and adding one probate clerk position and the travel memo. Is there any of these items that want to be pulled out for separate consideration? Next, under personnel notification, notification of resignation of Joseph Brent Helms, probate chief clerk, effective 3/18. Notification of Hattie Jean Duke serving as temporary acting chief clerk, replace Jay Helms, effective 3/21/16. Notification of resignation of Hannah Hall, tag clerk, effective 4/1/16. Next, reports to the commission. Ms. McDuffie, do you have a report tonight?
No, sir, I do not.
Any questions for the administrator? Next, Mr. Byer, do you have a report tonight?
Mr. Chairman, Commissioners, the only item I had is just want to make you aware that we are currently trying to work out all the details for May 21st at the Judicial Complex to be our next shred day, our annual shred day. This will fall between Mother's Day weekend and the Memorial Day weekend and miss our countywide cleanup days, so we think it's a good opportunity for us to do this. But that would be from 8 a.m. in the morning to 12 p.m. like we normally schedule. So I'll give that to Ms. Herbs. She can add that to y'all's calendar.
What day did you say?
May 21st, Saturday.
21st.
Yes, sir.
All right. Thank you, Mr. Byer. Mr. Jones, do you have anything tonight?
Just a couple of brief items. On March 17th, we hosted a National Weather Service spotter training class over in Millbrook at the Millbrook Civic Center. Had a decent turnout for that training class, and we just appreciate the National Weather Service coming down and providing that training for us. Also, we're continuing to assist some of the local jurisdictions on the disaster recovery work that they're doing on filing their paperwork. We're still working through some of that. And then we're in the process now of updating our tactical interoperable communications plan and resource inventory. We've started that process. And the only other thing that I would mention is just extending our condolences from the EMA office to the Haynes Lifelight and ambulance family after the tragedy that they had down in Coffee County. That's all of my report. Do y'all have any questions of me?
Any questions for Mr. Jones? Next, Mr. Weller, do you have a report tonight?
I do not, Mr. Chairman, but I'd be glad to answer any questions commissioners may have.
Any questions for the county attorney? Any report and calendar dates, Ms. Irv?
Saturday, April 9th is the next countywide cleanup day at just the Holtville and Central Elmer Water and Sewer Authority Redland Road locations from 9 to 1. Monday, April 11th is the next commission work session at 5 with the business meeting following.
Thank you. Reports to the commission. Commissioner Taylor, do you have anything tonight?
Yes, sir. I wanted to thank everybody for the thoughts and prayers in our time, my family's time of dismay, my mother passing, the food, the Facebook messages, the messages on the phones, calls and everything. I just want to thank everybody for sending those to us and sending the prayers and everything. It was much needed and much heard, and just wanted to thank everybody for doing that for our family.
Thank you, Commissioner Tutter. Commissioner Fault, do you have anything?
Yes, Mr. Chairman. I had committed to give a report on local voting activity after the elections on March 1. I had the opportunity to meet with the Republican officials, also meet with the probate judge and the sheriff, and also inspectors at different voting places. And what there's been a commitment to do, and I think this is very important because we do have a very important runoff election happening on April 12th as far as District 1 is concerned with the County Commission, is that the Republican Party has committed, there's different copies of, and all this is a learning experience for me, but when a voting machine, when one votes in a voting machine, copies of that tape are given at the end of the day to the probate office, the circuit clerk, to, in this case, because it is a primary, to the Republican Party, the Democratic Party. And the sheriff gets a copy. Even the media is given a copy of the different tapes that go in the machine. And the commitment's been made by the Republican Party leadership and also from the probate judge that those tapes will be compared at the end of the day, at the end of the election, for example, on April the 12th. When all the votes are in, then the Republican Party is committed to sit down with the probate office and compare and make sure that those votes are in agreement. And if they're not, then they will be challenged to find the additional votes or what have you. So I think that's very important. I think, after all, elections are not about candidates. Elections are about the people who vote for candidates. Because it's up to the people, and since we're the government for the people and by the people, it's very important that the people's message gets heard through a vote. And because of this importance, there's been a double commitment made, I know, from the people who are in charge of elections here, that being the probate office and the Republican Party, primarily in this case. And I want to thank them for all their diligence and as it regards voting. Also, I have a very sad note that I'm sure that all the commissioners are aware of, but I did want to bring it to the attention of those who are in the meeting. Dr. Robert Parker, who is a good friend of mine and also a community servant and has served on the Economic Development Authority for a number of years and also in so many voluntary positions, and also just probably one of the most outstanding men I ever met as far as Christian testimony was concerned, passed away on Friday, and his visitation is denied at his home, and they'll have a graveside service for him in Tallahassee tomorrow at 2 o'clock. That's all, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Commissioner Falk. Commissioner Smoak, do you have anything tonight?
No, Mr. Chairman, I do not.
Commissioner Rachel, do you have anything?
Nothing at this time.
And I have no report. I will adjourn the work session, and we'll get the agenda ready for the business meeting. All right, let's come to order. I'd like to ask Eric Jones to give our invocation and Commissioner Rachel lead us in our Pledge of Allegiance.
Let us pray. Dear God, we just come to you this evening, and more than anything in this season, dear God, we just thank you for the sacrifice you made in giving your Son, dear Lord, as you did for each of us, dear God. Help us to not take that for granted day to day. I know we celebrate it at Easter each year, dear God, but help us to remember it each day and help us to share your love and mercy and grace with the others that we come in touch with each and every day, and just help us to be busy about telling others about you, dear Lord. And dear Lord, again, we want to remember our soldiers overseas. We've had another fatality overseas from our military. And dear God, I just lift those families up to you. And just pray again for your comfort to rally around the families that have lost loved ones recently, and even those here, dear God, that serve us locally that have lost loved ones. And pray for the Haynes family. I pray for the Parker family. I pray for the Taylor family and many, many others here in our county, dear God, that just need your comfort, dear God, and just need your love. Just thank you for loving us and being there for us each and every day. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Stand for the pledge.
To the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Call the roll, please.
Commissioner Taylor?
Present.
Commissioner Falk?
Here.
Chairman Bowen?
Here.
Commissioner Rachel?
Yes.
Commissioner Daniel Smoak?
Present.
I have a motion to approve the minutes for the March 14, 2016 commission meeting as amended in the work session.
Motion.
Second.
Call roll.
Commissioner Taylor?
Yes.
Commissioner Falk?
Yes.
Chairman Bowen?
Yes.
Commissioner Rachel?
Yes.
Commissioner Daniel Smoak?
Yes.
Approved the memorandum of warrants for a period of March 10, 2016 through March 23, 2016.
Motion. Second.
Call the roll, please.
Commissioner Taylor?
Yes.
Commissioner Falk?
Yes.
Chairman Bowen?
Yes.
Commissioner Rachel?
Yes.
Commissioner Daniel Smoak?
Yes.
Under new business, a motion to approve or deny Revenue Commissioner mailing contract with Diversified Company, LLC.
Motion to approve.
Second.
Any discussion? Call the roll.
Commissioner Taylor?
Yes.
Commissioner Falk?
Yes.
Chairman Bowen?
Yes.
Commissioner Rachel?
Yes.
Commissioner Daniel Smoak?
Yes.
Motion to approve and deny bond issue parameters resolution for energy savings improvements to county facilities and authorize chairman to execute.
Motion to approve.
Second.
Have a motion and a second. Is there any discussion? Call the roll.
Commissioner Taylor?
Yes.
Commissioner Falk?
Yes.
Chairman Bowen?
Yes.
Commissioner Rachel?
Yes.
Commissioner Daniel Smoak?
Yes.
Motion to approve or deny Drug Task Force budget amendment.
Motion to approve.
Second.
Call the roll.
Commissioner Taylor?
Yes.
Commissioner Falk?
Yes.
Chairman Bowen?
Yes.
Commissioner Rachel?
Yes.
Commissioner Daniel Smoak?
Yes.
Motion to approve or deny county engineer executing lease for office copier pursuant to State of Alabama Contract T-190.
Motion.
Second.
Approve.
Motion to approve and a second by Commissioner Taylor. Any discussion? Call the roll.
Commissioner Taylor?
Yes.
Commissioner Falk?
Yes.
Chairman Bowen?
Yes.
Commissioner Rachel?
Yes.
Commissioner Daniel Smoak?
Yes.
Motion to approve or deny authorizing county engineer to execute agreement with ADEM for scrap tire cleanup on county right-of-ways for the remainder of FY 16, 17, and 18.
Motion to approve.
Second.
Have a motion and a second. Any discussion? Call roll.
Commissioner Taylor?
Yes.
Commissioner Falk?
Yes.
Chairman Bowen?
Yes.
Commissioner Rachel?
Yes.
Commissioner Daniel Smoak?
Yes.
A motion to approve or deny agreement with ADM for Alabama Scrap Tire Fund Marketing Demonstration Project.
Motion to approve.
Second.
Have a motion and a second. Any discussion? Call roll.
Commissioner Taylor?
Yes.
Commissioner Falk?
Yes.
Chairman Bowen?
Yes.
Commissioner Rachel?
Yes.
Mr. Daniel Snyder?
Yes.
Motion to approve or deny FY16 Local Road Program.
Motion to approve.
Second.
Have a motion and a second. Any discussion? Call roll.
Commissioner Taylor?
Yes.
Commissioner Falk?
Yes.
Chairman Bowen?
Yes.
Commissioner Rachel?
Yes.
Mr. Daniel Snyder?
Yes.
Move we approve the consent docket.
No, second.
Call roll.
Commissioner Taylor?
Yes.
Commissioner Falk?
Yes.
Chairman Bowen?
Yes.
Commissioner Rachel?
Yes.
Mr. Daniel Snyder?
Yes.
Ms. McDuffie, do you have any further? Mr. Byer, do you have anything further? Mr. Jones? Mr. Weller?
No, sir, no.
Do I have a motion to adjourn?
So move.
Second.
Have a motion and a second. Call roll.
Commissioner Taylor?
Yes.
Commissioner Falk?
Yes.
Chairman Bowen?
Yes.
Commissioner Rachel?
Yes.
Mr. Daniel Snyder?
Yes.
We're adjourned.